just like Pastor Owen. We are mavericks. Mavericks means what? You do things differently. Okay? So we tend to attract people who like to think new and progressive. But at the same time, our ministry sometimes will attract a lot of criticism. So be prepared to listen with an open mind. But don't be so open that the brains fall out. Listen with a critical spirit constructively, and then you will learn. I always ask people, when I say something that you are not used to it, don't react, okay? Because according to the Bereans, when they hear the teaching of Paul, did they contradict him? No, they went back to look at the scripture to find out whether he said it's true or not. It should be like that. If I say something that you already know, why are you here? Okay? So you always come with a mind ready to learn, not ready to find fault. We are pathfinders, you know, we are not fault finders. Now, the liver and gallbladder cleanse. Last year, I graduated from Master's in Public Health. And my master's degree is the effects of liver cleanse on blood cholesterol. By the way, liver cleanse can prevent and alleviate many diseases. But why I only focus on blood cholesterol? Because it can be measured. And second reason is I need to graduate. I cannot go and focus on other things, you know, on and on, and there's no end to it. Now, I'd like to introduce this lady. If you go to any organic shop, you ask, do you know who is Dr. Lai Chunan? And those who speak Mandarin, Lai Chunan, they will all know who she is. Okay? She's a Taiwanese American cancer researcher at University of Texas Cancer Center for 10 years. After 10 years of cancer research, she was very disappointed. She went back to Taiwan and China to study natural remedies. Because cancer treatment in the West, they never grow in their understanding. Because they only learn how to remove tumors through surgery, chemotherapy, and radiotherapy. And that's it. And as a result, some people die faster as a result of chemo and radiotherapy. Am I right? So she said, she found out through her research, cancer is never the first illness. Usually there are a lot of other problems leading to cancer. In other words, if a person got cancer, they already got other problems already. And in her research, she said, people with cancer usually have stones. We all have gallstones. It's a matter of big or small, many of you. The older you are, the more stones you have. So when I present this to my professors, they never learn about this. Then my professor asked me, so how many stones usually a person can pass from? I say about 4,000. They say, wow, can build a house. Actually, later on, I realized that it's more than that. It's more than 4,000 stones. I showed you this morning, you know, a lot of people die of this lifestyle disease. Now, in the Western world, the guru for liver cleanse is Andreas Mores. But in the Eastern world, is Lai Chunan. Now, who is this guy? This guy is a naturopath. Before he became a naturopath in natural remedy, he had all these diseases, and he'd been taking medication, and he suffered from the side effects of medication more than the disease itself. So he decided to stop all this medication and learn about natural remedy. And he wrote this very famous book called The Liver and Gallbladder Miracle Cleanse. You can buy this book through this website. Okay, if you type, or you can buy from Amazon. Okay, this is my reference book for my thesis. Now, the proposition of this liver and gallbladder cleanse. sentence is very simple. It says, you never drive the car until it stops. Then you ask the mechanic to tow it, right? You never do that. You do regular servicing to maintain your car so that it will never break down. Am I right? But we never do that for the body. We wait until we are sick, we go and see a doctor, and we expect medication, right? So, something wrong with us. Our car is better maintained than our body. The car, we put the best oil, best petrol. For us, we put rubbish, we go for miracle healing. Something is not right. So what do you do when you service your car? You take out your old oil, change the oil filter and the air filter. Then you put in the new oil. Am I right? So if your car breaks down, you go to the mechanic, say, oh, I introduced this very good black oil, I pour inside, it will become okay. You believe? You believe? You don't believe, am I right? But how come when you are sick, you go and see doctor? You don't believe in doctor, you believe in those supplements, right? You keep putting things in before taking things out. Something is wrong. See, we do something logical for other things, but for our body, we do something illogical and we think that it's normal. So today, I'm not only going to shake you, I'm going to hurt you. Literally. Take the poison out. When you renovate your house, do you keep all the old furniture? No. Before you bring new furniture, you take out the old furniture. But how come you put new things in before taking things out? What's the problem? The problem is toxicity. How do we become toxic? How can we detoxify? That's very important. Now, pollutants and pollution are a serious problem. No, virtually everything that we live in are all producing chemicals. You make a bench, you have lights. See, all these are produced, all these are negative energy. Other people are talking about it, we are not talking about it. Okay, we only have the New Start. You all know what is New Start? But what about the OM? Why O-N? O-N is the opposite of new, start and end. So I'm playing around with words. See, a lot of people when they attend New Start, their bodies are already dilapidated by many years of neglect or abuse. So you ask them to exercise and eat good food while all the toxins are inside. Can they exercise while they already have arthritis? Can they eat all the whole grains while they got digestion problem? So we teach them new stuff without teaching them the whole end. Look at this. This is American statistics. Okay. 40 pounds of additives per year, 160 pounds of sugar, 8 pounds of salt, and 10,000 chemicals. Actually, we should not eat canned food. Very ironical, we cannot eat canned food. Cannot. Okay. Do you see your favorite food? Huh? This one? This one? This one? This one? What's wrong with that? You see, hydrogenated fats, they are called the trans fat, that will raise your bad cholesterol up. It's better to eat an apple than to drink apple juice. Okay, how do toxins enter our body? Through these three areas, through our digestive tract, through skin penetration, and through our lungs. Now ladies, if you were to spray perfume, don't spray on your skin, spray on your clothes. Okay. You can't control what you breathe, right? But you can choose where you stay. But you can control what you eat. That's why the Chinese believe 90% of the diseases is as a result of what we eat. Bing chong ko lu. Am I right? Those Chinese. Diseases come, you are banana. What a big one. Are the stones that are perched up. By the way, she didn't perch up the 50 cent coin. The Singapore 50 cent coin is placed there to compare the size. If every time I perch 50 cent, I'll do it every day. Now, guess how old is this lady who has done the detox? These are not feces. These are actually gallstones. You tell a lady. Yeah, I'm telling her. How old she is, I want you to guess. Based on the toxins that I've passed off. That's what I thought. If you are, if you've never done detox before, you will pass up stones that are like this. If you are in your 40s and 50s, but she is only 22 years old. When I have learned how to diagnose your disease based on the stones that you pass up. Yeah. So I look at it. What cholesterol? These are all the parasites. This is all the toxins. These are deep cholesterol. Okay. Then I ask her, excuse me, do you drink alcohol? She said, yes. Do you smoke? She said, yes. I said, you pass out stones that are supposed to be ladies who are in their 40s. So your lifestyle will determine the toxins that you have. Toxins that are passed out will tell about your lifestyle. It can never lie. So it's very important for you to drink water. That's why first thing in the morning you must drink water, because 70% of our system is made out of water. Our brain, 90%. 75%, sorry. Because of chlorine, it causes cancer. Hey Malaysians, do you all filter your water? Singapore, very strange, only 10% filter their water. In Malaysia, 90%. Because they trust Singapore government more than they trust Yeah. We don't riot so in Singapore. We treat our government like our fathers. So, look at this. Even in Singapore, after 3 months, so can you imagine people have been drinking water from the tap without filtration? This one will go into your blood and reside in your joints. That's why some people have all this joint pain. So this is already 3 months. Can you imagine times 4, that will be 1 year. Times 30, that will be your age. All the accumulated toxins, you have not been detoxifying. Can you imagine? By the way, when you eat outside, do they filter the water? They never filter the water. If you eat outside most of the time, you are eating all these sediments and rust plus chlorine. Kali means additives. So we should drink water that is below 50 ppm. Okay, that water is 150 to 400 ppm, all the pollutants. That's why diamond water after filtration is 33. You can drink. I'm not promoting diamond, I'm promoting simple water filter system that is found in Malaysia. See the Panasonic? Okay, don't talk about water, come back to the point. If you do detox and you don't have good water, no point. Okay. What do your body do with toxins? By the way, if your liver is healthy, it's not clogged, it's able to remove toxins. But after some time, your liver will be clogged. If you just like your oil filter and air filter. So what happens? Your liver cannot manage all these toxins. it will deposit them in your tissues and bury them on the body fats. That's why some people have spare tires, not only in their cars, but also on their bodies. How do you know you got spare tire? You can't see your toes. You can't see your toes. You got spare tire. Okay, your chest must be bigger than your waist. But if your waist is bigger than your chest, you have a lot of toxins. That's for men. For ladies, if your waist is bigger than your chest, I got nothing to say. Okay? You may have to use a mirror to see your toes. That's why if you are overweight, you go for weight loss program. Your weight will come back because your toxins are still in your body. Those commercial weight loss programs are only helping you to lose water. They are not helping you to lose weight. Now, these are the major organs of detoxification. But the most important one is your liver. The liver is the largest organ besides the skin. And it's the only organ that will regenerate itself. That means that if you donate your liver and give it to somebody, if you donate one third, the one third will grow back. And the one that receives one third, it will grow to a full size liver. Okay, it's like your mother who never complained. Work day and night. Right? But when the mother complains, the whole family is in trouble, am I right? That's why when the liver complains on it, that's it. Okay, there are 500 functions of the liver. If I talk about every function of it, you have to stay here until midnight. Okay? Stay here until midnight the next day, not today. So I'd rather focus on 7 major functions. Number one is an immune system. Okay, it's immunity against infection. You know, some people fall sick once a month. Have you discovered? Some people fall sick when everybody falls sick. And some people fall sick after they receive their pay the next day. So if you don't want to fall sick, you need to unclog your liver because the liver is in charge of filtration. Okay, it filters the blood from impurities. It also is a factory for protein and cholesterol. It also excretes waste via bile. Bile is a greenish substance to digest fat. Okay, and then it also converts excess glucose to starch for storage. Now, let's say for example, you overeat, you become a gluttony. By the way, gluttony is one of the 7 sins, right? If you overeat, what will happen? You have extra protein, extra cholesterol, extra waste, extra fat, extra sugar. Then your liver will overwork. When your liver overworks, all these cholesterol, fats, you develop fatty liver, all this cholesterol will be deposited in your brain vessels and your heart vessels. That's why you have all these circulatory problems. You understand what I'm saying? And when you are sick, you go and see a doctor, they give you drugs that further intoxicate your liver. Because all medication, all nutrients has to go through the liver. Am I right? So what happens if you take soft drinks, you have chemicals, and you go for happy hour, not amenities, you have alcohol. So what happened? No wonder a lot of people die faster. Okay. So your blood clotting mechanism will be affected. Then you have a whole system of disease coming to us. Now this is the liver. These are the hepatic ducts. For layman term, we call it the liver ducts. Okay. These liver ducts, over the years, will accumulate this liver stones, or we call it gallstones. And you know that this is the gallbladder. Liver and gallbladder is in charge of digesting fat. That's why in Chinese there is a saying, gan dan xiang zao. Means what? The liver and gallbladder work hand in hand to digest. Those people with gastric problem means what? Their liver and gallbladder is blocked. They cannot secrete enough bile to protect the stomach from the gastric juice. So when somebody tells me, Pastor, I have gastric, straight away I will say you have a serious congestion. There's not enough bile secreted. Now, how many of you have friends or you yourself heard about people who got gallstones problem? Can I see a show of hands? You see, last time, if you have gallstones, the doctor will remove the stones. Nowadays, no more. If you have gallstone problem, they will remove the gallbladder. Why? Anyone knows? Okay, I'll tell you one. When you remove the stones, excess stones from the liver will go into the gallbladder. And then it becomes calcified again. So the doctor don't want to be responsible for being accused if you do not do your good job. So they remove your gallbladder, no more pain. But no more pain is what? The disease is still there. Your liver is clogged. Now, very serious, God put a gallbladder for a purpose. What is the purpose of the gallbladder? Anybody can tell me? To store bile. It has a 5 times concentration of bile. So in other words, if you eat a lot of fatty food, the liver will secrete a lot of bile, but excess bile will be stored into the gallbladder. It's just like when it rains. In PJ, PJ don't have drains, don't have reservoir. Where all the water go to? No river. It will be flooded. Same here, when you don't have a gallbladder, all the bile will go into your intestines. It will flood your gut, your colon. Okay? So the doctor take away the gallbladder means what? Take away the pain. They are actually pain managers. I know some people don't like me when I say that. Okay, but this is the truth. So what should you do? Do a liver cleanse. All the new gallstones will be purged out. All the old ones will be ready to be purged the next time. Okay. Now, what is this? Pancreas. Pancreas is in charge of secreting what? Enzymes as well as insulin to store sugar, am I right? Now, do you know that there are two kinds of diabetes, type 1 and type 2? Type 2 is after 40, you will get it if you do not take care of your health. Now, listen. The gallbladder shares a common duct together with the pancreas. If your gallbladder is clogged with stones, some of the excess stones will be clogged on the end of the common duct. So when this is blocked, the pancreas cannot secrete enzymes to digest. So some of the enzymes become very corrosive and digest the pancreas itself. So when the pancreas is being digested, you cannot secrete insulin. That's why people who recently diagnosed with diabetes, quickly ask them to do a cleanse to unblock these stones to save the pancreas. Because I don't know whether you know or not, when you are initially diagnosed with diabetes, doctor will give you medication of insulin, right? Then as the years go by, the dosage increase until finally you have to inject, right? That means your pancreas will slowly be destroyed. So if you are diagnosed with diabetes for the first 5 years, quickly do a cleanse to save your pancreas. Now, if you don't, if those people don't believe me, never mind. You do a cleanse, you have nothing to lose, right? Except stones. plans, you have nothing to lose except stones. Maybe it's in the afternoon, no strength to laugh. Some people don't believe our liver got stones. They cut out this liver and let you see. This is a very toxic liver. Very clogged. Some of the liver has parasites. And some people's favorite food is the liver. Right? It's the most toxic meat because it really filters the blood. Even a healthy liver has stones. Now what happens if you have a clogged liver? You will have detoxification problem. And then in the end, you have oxidative stress. Oxidative stress means what? It cannot. It becomes very toxic and it will encourage free radicals production. What is free radicals? Free cancer stage. Right? And then you lead to a lot of health problems like joint problem, cardiovascular and all this. Then the next one will be cancer. That's why Dr. Lai Chun-Nan said, before you have cancer, you have all these problems. And then you have this problem, you go and see doctor, doctor will give you drugs. Drugs will further overload your liver. It's a vicious cycle of toxic overload. This is a 50-cent coin. Can you imagine how big the spoons are? Some people say, hey, hold on, hey, pastor. The liver gut is so small, how can the stone be passed out? Then I say, hey, the baby's head is so small, how can it come out from your mother's birth canal? Baby's head is made of bones, you know? This one is fat, so fats can squeeze out. Right? She has a borderline high cholesterol. Okay. This lady, she's got gallstone problem and she had intense pain and she was due for surgery to remove the gallbladder. She doesn't believe in that. She came and see me. So she did two sessions of liver cleanse and she passed out these calcified stones. Different color means different problems. Look at these calcified stones. Calcified stones are black and they can be seen through ultrasound. Other colors cannot be seen because it's still in fat form. Only in calcified form you can be seen in ultrasound. Yes, after a while. This one is what? This one is not gay ji. 不是枸杞子. These are not wolfberry. It's not wolfberry. What are these? These are chemical deposits. So when I look at her, I say, wow, did you take a lot of medication? She said, yes, I've been taking medication for 20 over years. So the stones that you pass out will tell me of your lifestyle. Okay. I look at you, I can roughly say, how many of you have got stones? But I can't tell you whether you have been taking medication. But when you pass out all this, I will know. I can tell you whether you smoke or not when you pass out. Now this young gentleman, he has eczema. Eczema is what? It's a, in Chinese it's called what? You know that eczema has no cure? When you see a doctor, doctor only give you steroid-based cream. And steroid is very harmful to the liver. You know that? And some serious case that they have to inject. So what they do, steroids actually suppress the immune system. So So eczema is actually immune system problem. Remember, our body detox in four ways: through our feces, through our urine, through our breath, and through our skin. So if our detoxification system is not functioning well, the body will try to detox in other ways. So when a person has eczema, it means that the poison is in the body trying to find its way out. You understand? So when I ask him to go for detox, this is his second cleanse, you know. Look at all the toxins that he passed up. This is now when I say first detox, second purge, means in one detox you can purge 5 times to 7 times. So this is second purge. This is his third detox, first purge. Look at all the parasites. These are also parasites. Third detox, second purge.
How do you separate?
Just when you pass out, right, you use a shower head. The feces will disintegrate. Parasites and stones will not disintegrate. This one cannot be recycled. Some people want to collect the stones. For other people to see, you must freeze it. But you must label it, otherwise people will thought it's a bean. Mix it with the salad finish. Okay, you need to know, people with parasites, if the parasite feed on your nutrients and then they excrete, very toxic for your body. So another reason why people have all these allergy problems like asthma, eczema. So people with eczema, usually they have childhood asthma. I don't know whether you notice. They are all interlinked. Okay? So it's better to do a detox. And today, he has done 6 sessions of detox. You look at his skin, very beautiful. No more drugs. He went to see doctors and those Chinese doctors, cannot cure. And by the way, drugs are usually for chronic illness you have to take for life. Am I right? So you are slave to the drugs. So this lady has hepatitis in her 30s. Look at all the parasites. Don't ask how much. Today is 7. It's free. It's good to begin with the end in mind, but don't ask it. Later I'll tell you. Later. Same lady, after she passed out all these parasites, she passed out more stones. These are the toxins. So in her 30s already, she passed out all this. She's a hepatitis B carrier. So people with a hepatitis B carrier, the next stage will be cirrhosis and cancer. So if you do a detox, you are delaying the onset of cancer. So what are the signs and symptoms to show that your liver is blocked? These are the signs. By the way, constipation, we need to redefine what is constipation. Constipation means you feel the urge to go to the toilet and then how you try only one drop. that's constipation, right? But the new definition is that if you go to the toilet once a day, you're already constipated. You want to follow real way to detox, you follow the birds, the cows and the elephants. Yeah, every now and then. By right, we should go to the toilet 3 times a day because we eat 3 meals. But if you go to the toilet once a day, you're already constipated. I go to the toilet 3 or 4 times a day. Yeah. Okay. Hernia. You see, all the diseases have to do with female, not like hernia, not hymnia. menstrual, menopause. Now, osteoporosis. Okay, you know what causes osteoporosis? Let me explain to you. Osteoporosis is caused by liver problem. The liver also in charge of absorbing calcium. When the liver is clogged, your body do not have enough calcium. So they will draw calcium from the bones. Okay, this is one of my church members. She has premenstrual cramp. How many of you ladies have premenstrual cramps? Some people, the menstrual cramp is so painful. So painful that they have to take heavy painkillers. And some of them, when they are in pain, they can stop going to work. Right? So, this lady, I asked her to go for cleanse. She quite out of this. When she first did her cleanse, 50% of her pain gone. When she do a second time, 100% of the pain gone. Now, what causes pain? I want to tell you. Pain is caused by congestion because of the pressure. Just like gallstone, when you have gallstone, it congested the secretion of bile. And when you eat fatty food, the body tried to secrete bile and then there was a pressure. So same here, no? When your system tries to purge out all the bad blood, it cannot purge out properly because of congestion. So you need to decongestion. Same here, your got headache, chest pain, you need to decongest your clot. Okay, due to toxins. You know, in America, a lot of people got Alzheimer's disease. You know why? Do you know why? Because they eat a lot of chemical food, fast food, all come from there, canned food, soft drinks. Okay. Do you have this? If you have this, very lucky.
These are the stones that have been with me
since I was born. You know, when you're a vegetarian, you pass motion, and the motion is not so smelly one. But the day when I passed this out, like, my wife couldn't go into the toilet. It was overpowering. The toxins has been there for 40 over years. So you better, those who are old, you better detox now, otherwise you have to renovate the toilet after that.
Require different degrees of overhaul. In other words, if you are very healthy,
chronic diseases up to 10 times. Cancer patients can be up to 15 times. I'm going to show you some of the... This guy is a Filipino. He has a very severe eczema. Eczema got two types, the dry one and the wet one. He got the wet type. So after 9 cleanses, look at the skin. He stopped all the steroids. Because steroids have a lot of side effect. Especially ladies, if you take too much steroids, you start to grow hair. You follow your husband to shave. Yeah. And then for men, they start taking steroids, right? Hey, how come they have to wear bra? Serious. Liver spots, ladies. Okay? Some of them want to grow young, right? They go to have their facial. Some even go for Botox. I say, don't go for Botox. Botox is injecting toxins. Go for detox. Right? If you like panda eyes, don't detox. Do you have a sleep late? If you sleep after 12, you will have this. Do a cleanse. See this? You see, this one you can use cosmetic to cover. This one you can. So you do a cleanse, see what happened? Also, toxins finding its way out. Body age. If you want to age gracefully, do a detox. If you want your hairline to remain, you know nowadays it's very common for guys to shave ball. Right? Because they got hair ball, shave ball. It's also due to toxins. Now this is my research. Share with you my research. What causes heart disease? Abnormal blood lipids, unhealthy diet, physical activity. These are something that you can modify. Your more modifiable is your age, your hereditary, and your gender. Of course, age you can delay the onset. Hereditary you cannot change. Gender you can't change. Of course, some people in Thailand try to. Okay, this is cholesterol. Okay. You know high blood pressure? Caused by cholesterol built when your heart vessels is blocked, your heart has to pump extra hard. That's why you got high blood pressure. Okay. So this lady, I told you she got middle borderline high cholesterol. She wrote me an email. Okay, can you read them?
I said, well, you read.
Hi, Mark. Want to share some good news? I think my second cleansing in early October. But as many big stones came out as in the first cleansing, mainly many small yellowish stones. Previously for a year, my LDL was hovering at borderline high range, example between 3.4 to 4.0, despite going for regular exercise and trying to control my diet. What was successful in lowering my LDL? I refused to take medication, only to break his rice supplements already and doctor warned me that if my LDL rating is not lower, he would definitely have to put me on statins.
What are statins? It's a drug to lower cholesterol.
One week after the second cleansing, I went for my blood test for cholesterol, etc. at the polyclinic. I'm happy to report that my LDL went down to 2.41, which is at the optimal range of below 2.6. So I'm thankful that you came to see me and introduced me to your method of liver and gallstones cleansing. Honestly, I was rather skeptical at first, but now I'm convinced that it works. My blood test results is proof of that.
Because of this email, I decided to use this as my thesis topic. I thank God for this. You know what? I'm the first person to finish my thesis. The rest of them have a hard time finishing thesis. Thesis is the most headache. Okay? So this is my AUB degree, Master's in Public Health. and this is my project title: Effects of Liver Cleanse on Blood Cholesterol Level Among Adults in Singapore. What year? Okay.
Last year.
Last year. No, this one is last year. It was 2011. The email given to me was almost 3 years ago. Okay. So this is my thesis. I submitted my thesis. Now, these are the blood test results. That's why I cannot share with you the PowerPoint because it's very confidential. I have to block up the name. This is a 47-year-old lady. So on June 2011, we did a blood test on the lipid profile. Her total cholesterol was 243, which is considered very high. And then her LDL, which is bad cholesterol, also very high. So she became my experimental group subject, one of the subjects. And she did two cleanses with 2 weeks in between. So 5 weeks later, we did another blood test. Look at the result. Compare the cholesterol from 243 dropped to 167, which is healthy range. And the bad cholesterol LDL 151, it becomes 109. It is still not optimal yet. She can drop some more if she do more cleanses. Statistics don't lie, right? Later. Later. Still early, huh? You know what? A lot of people say, hey, can you tell me how much? Tell me about liver cleanse. I always tell them, you must be convinced and convicted first before you do natural remedy. Otherwise, you will never do it because it's troublesome. People are so used to popping pills for shortcut. This is not shortcut. You must be convicted. And in order to convict people, I must show them scientific proof. By the way, very few natural remedies have scientific proof. Do you know that? If I show this to the doctors, they will feel very threatened because I'm threatening their rice bowl. Am I right? Testimony is all feeling. Blood test is the best. Am I right? When I showed this, when I graduated in Philippines, one doctor came to my church and asked me to present to a group of specialists at Manila Cemetery. I tell you, I got persecuted left, right, center. Yeah. Because they believe in conventional treatment, they don't believe in that. When they saw these stones, they say, these are not stones, these are feces. I said, these are not feces, these are stones. It's nonsense. So they attack me. They say, oh, you're... But they ignore this. They ignore this. They attack me on other slides. Then finally, I got so angry, I scold them back. I told them, I thought Filipinos are nice people. Is that how you treat a guest like me? I'm not a doctor like you, you know. I'm only a pastor taking my master in public health. Is that how you treat me? Well, the doctor who invited me, feel so embarrassed, you know, by the behavior of the doctor. I tell you, a prophet is not welcome in his own home. Even when in Singapore, some of those people who believe in New Start, they say all sorts of things about my program. And by the way, you need to know, you need to know this. When I do this thesis, right, I have to have a thesis proposal. That means you cannot anyhow study a thesis without the panel approval. So the AUP sent a panel of professors to approve my title. They call it the defense title. After my presentation, the professor discussed, and okay, we let you study. Guess what? I got A you know, for my defense title proposal. And then later on, the division health director questioned the panel head and said, how come you allow Pastor Mark Chan to study this? Our church won't believe in this kind of thing. Because Adam might never talk about G-Pops. health faculty. AUB, the MPH program. So what happened was, you know how the professor answered the SSD director, the divisional health director? He said, Pastor Chan is going to use a natural remedy and there will be blood tests. If this is questionable, that is disease, prove it. Okay, I'm going to show you more results. Huh? This gentleman is 45 years old. He has high triglycerides. Other things are normal except high triglycerides. What is triglycerides? Triglycerides are fats in the blood. That means that if you don't take care of it, you have diabetes. So after two cleanses, look at his result. Wow, he was so thankful. Okay, that he did the cleanse. Okay, this is the result of my thesis. I'm going to show you the abstract. I have 84 participants on a purpose sampling method. 50 form the experimental group. In other words, they are the ones who take the blood test, do two cleanses, and then take a blood test later. Yes. And then 34 form the control group. That means they take the blood test, they exercise, they change their diet, but they didn't do a liver cleanse. Okay? This is a control group. And what's the result? The experimental group does lower LDL significantly when exercise and age are considered. So this is the result. Number two, a significant difference in terms of LDL between those who exercise regularly and those who do not. So my liver cleanse natural remedy is also holistic. It encourages people to change their lifestyle through eating properly and exercise. And participants in the experimental group between 50 to 59 years of age had a gain score which is statistically significant. In other words, if you are doing liver cleanse, if you fall between the age of 50 to 59, it is more helpful for you. Why? Because those people have more stones. They have higher cholesterol than those who are younger. And their results are more significant. That's all. Now, we should not encourage people to take statins. Why? Because it has all the side effects. Especially liver and muscle damage. Liver and muscle breakdown. Liver damage. All kinds of generic or medical brands of statins are not good. Statins is prevent your liver to produce cholesterol, whereas all the toxins are still there. So you have to take for life. It's a life sentence, you know, once you take statins. You see, all the problem. Now, your liver is a normal liver. After a while, if all the stones are there, it becomes a cirrhosis liver. See? See these stones, instead of passing out, it becomes part of the liver. It clots the liver. And in the end, it becomes like that. When it becomes like that, you have to go for liver transplant. Now, one of my experimental group subject, she has cancer. I didn't know. She also doesn't know. She passed out this same lady. Instead of stones, she had a layer of sludge. A very toxic stones, brown. See, this is a parasite. Another lady, she's not part of my experimental group. She's from an outside community. She attended one of my talks. She's a Christian. After she attended my talk, she went to pray about it. She got breast cancer, removed the breast already, and done all the chemo. She's worried that the cancer will come back. So she prayed about it. After listening to my talk, she decided to go for the cleanse. And she passed out a layer of sludge. A thick layer of sludge. Huh? Multicolors. You name it, she has it. Once you reach cancer, all the illnesses you have, you name it, she will have it. I don't want to show you all the different, because she has done the first cleanse. I only fast forward to show you the ninth cleanse because I'm afraid if I show you so much, your lunch will come out. I show you the nine detox. After the nine detox, look at the stones. All these cholesterol stones will come out. A 10 detox. 11, 12, 13, 14. When she passed out this little amount of stones after the 14 detox, I told her, congratulations, sister. You have finished your overhaul cleanse as a cancer patient. She looks prettier, younger, and more attractive. Yeah. When I saw her before she do her cleanse and after she do her cleanse, she's totally indistinguishable. I don't want you to believe me, because I have so many critics. You do it yourself. Right? We can talk about the gospel. Come and taste. Come and see. Experiment yourself. Now for cancer patients, the servicing cleanse is half a year once. Normal people, once a year. So she is very obedient. 6 months later, I call her up and your sister is due for your servicing cleanse. She passed this out. Her first servicing cleanse after the 14 cleanses. Look at her stones. Is it smaller? Lesser? See statistics? I mean, what you pass up, don't lie. Although it's still very toxic. But it's not. This is the first purge. Look at the second purge. She's due for another cleanse in 2 months' time. I'm going to... No time to tell you. In future, if I come again, I'll show you the progress. A lot of people, when they have cancer, they do all sorts of treatment. They are so afraid that the cancer will come back. I tell you, more than 50% of the people, the cancer will come back. Because the oncologist will tell them, you can eat anything. Right? Actually, they are the most ignorant. Sorry, yeah. If you have friends who are doctors, I offend them, really. Yeah. But this is the fact. Doctors, they never study nutrition. They only study one module in their whole entire life. So what the nutritionists know and what they know is totally different. Okay, I'm going to answer your question, brother. Are you ready to wake up? Now you can wake up again.
Residue feces and to kill
parasites, and also to relax the liver dust. It's a very powerful mineral. According to the Health Science Authority in Singapore, magnesium is a health supplement. And health supplements do not need to apply permit. So, a lot of people say, hey, can I try your medicine? I correct that, this is not medicine. This is a natural food supplement. Okay, are you ready? Don't have to take, because I know to give it to you. Okay, ready? Are you ready? According to Dr. Lai Chunan, the liver cleanse is actually a 6-day cleanse. But we are shortening it to an 18-hour cleanse. I mean, who got 6 days? You all have to work, right?
Yeah.
So we are shortening it for city people. Day one is preparation. Day two is flushing day. Okay? So let's say, for example, if your off day is on Sunday, when is your preparation day? Saturday. We don't talk about Sabbath here. We are talking about detox. So your preparation day, you can still come to church. Okay? So you must do some preparation work. What are the preparation work? Number one, for breakfast you eat fruits. You can eat all kinds of fruits except durian. Okay, I qualify. All kinds of fruits except durian. Now some people, when they eat banana, they can move their bowel. Some people eat banana, they constipate. So to play safe, don't eat bananas. Okay, so all kinds of fruits you can eat except durian or bananas. And then you drink lots of water. And then from noon to 1 o'clock, you eat vegetables. All kinds of vegetables, preferably raw. And if you have to eat, cook one, just blanch it and quickly take out and eat it. No cooking, no frying, no oil, no meat, no milk, okay?
Salt.
No eggs.
Salt.
What is that?
Salt.
No salt. So on that day, you know some foods have natural salt. Use the natural one. Are you ready? Okay, you got it, huh? And then, eat until you're full for breakfast and for lunch. Why? You are eating all this fiber, to really purge up your intestines. And then, 6 o'clock, you fast for dinner. If you are hungry, drink water. And some people cannot take it, they drink juice. The juice must not have pulp. In other words, it's not blended juice, but juice. Fiber and water separate, drink the water. Why? Because once you have pulp, it requires digestion. Now, you notice that all these do not have oil, so that your liver can rest. Our first time in history, your liver rests. It's just like Mother's Day, they don't work. 8 o'clock, you take 4 capsules of magnesium, it's in capsule, open up the capsule, put the powder here, pour the lemon juice. There is a scale for you to measure, 150 ml. Shake the lemon juice together with the magnesium, and then you drink. And then at 10 o'clock, you pour the olive oil together with the lemon juice, become 150 ml of olive oil, 150 ml of lemon juice. But if you are 60 kg and below, you are below 60 kg, it's 125 olive oil. But lemon juice the same, 150. So let's say for example, 150, 150, 300, you shake it. Shake it for 1 minute, and then you have the emulsified solution. You put a straw and you drink. Drink it in 2 minutes. But some people don't listen to my instruction. Everything come out. Drink it slowly because this is the difficult part. If you drink it too fast, it will regurgitate. Now, why you use a straw? So that you don't taste it. Sour and oily together. Wow. So, what happened? You drink it slowly. And some people cannot take it, very nausea. Cut a piece of ginger and suck the ginger. Or take honey to wash it down. Pure honey. And then after you have done it, that's 10 o'clock. Immediately lie down on your bed. Lie down on this. Turn to your right. Why to your right? Because your liver is on the right. Okay, that's where your liver will secrete power. Okay, in large quantity. And then the magnesium will dilate the liver ducts. The lemon will loosen the stones. For 20 minutes, don't move. After 20 minutes, you can go to the toilet to empty your bowels or your bladder. Using bladder, the bowels will not come. Okay? And then you sleep until the next day. That will be the first time in your life you sleep at 10 o'clock. Right? You night owls. Right? And then the next day, it's your flushing day where you do not go to work. Stay at home until at least 3 p.m. Every time you purge, you drink one glass of water. So what happens? Open two capsules. Pour warm water, shake and drink. Only warm, cold not allowed. Because cold will constrict, warm will dilate. 8 o'clock, repeat what you do at 6 o'clock. No, I didn't bring the whole thing here. Usually in my kit, I have lemon juice, olive oil, and then a basket. I didn't bring a basket. So the basket, you're supposed to buy yourself, olive oil and lemon juice you buy yourself. So the basket, right? Those people who are morning person, after 6 o'clock, you will take the medicine, you will come out already. So the first purge, don't collect. Second purge, collect. After you collect, right? Leave the thing there. Toilet bowl, I'm talking about. Use the shower heads. All the feces dispersed. All the nice gems are there. Take a picture and WhatsApp me.
Very telling.
first time and they lost 2 kg. Immediately you lose 2 kg. But it's not proportional, it doesn't mean that you do 10 detox, you lose 20 kg. If you weigh 40 kg, you lose 20 kg. You'll be in ICU already. These are the benefits of a liver cleanse. But some people say, huh? Libu, improve like libido, I'll do. I say you do for other reasons also. Okay, these are all the benefits of a liver cleanse. Okay, this lady is from Singapore. She is the number one in the New Skin. You heard of New Skin? Huh? She's number one, but now she's in KL, you know. Huh? KL has a New Skin, do you know that? She come to Malaysia to expand her network. She appeared in 2 years ago under investment. She's a very successful entrepreneur using New Skin. I already know her before she was famous. She came for my vegetarian cooking demonstration. So when I saw her appear on paper, I called her to congratulate her. And she asked me, what are you doing? I said, I'm doing liver cleanse for people. She came and heard my talk and she did liver cleanse. You see, she's about 52. But when she was 35 years old, she began to live a healthy lifestyle. But when she was born until when she was 35, she lived a very bad lifestyle. She was a banker, lived a fast-paced life, eat all sorts of rubbish. But when she became a vegetarian, not only a vegetarian, vegan, practice yoga, more healthier than me. She passed out all these parasites. This kind of cholesterol. By the way, I already got her permission. If in case you know her, you will complain to her that I show. She already got her permission. When I saw all this, I asked her to go for blood cholesterol test. I thought she got high cholesterol. Actually, she didn't have very low. But the point I want to tell you is, if you were to buy a car from an owner who didn't take care of the car, the carbon, the toxins are still in the car. No matter how careful you drive from now on as a good driver, it doesn't make the car improve. Same here. If you have been living a bad lifestyle, you go for a new start, your toxins are still inside. Am I right? Unless you do the detox. Same here. When she heard about detox, she can complement with her supplements. Wow, powerful. This is from her. Okay. This is her husband. The husband used to be a smoker. Now look at, she eat all the brown rice. See, among the brown rice also, they got all these toxins. The husband, worse than her. The smoke. But together, two of them live a healthy lifestyle for the last 17 years. But the toxins are still there. Any question?
What happens to the person who has liver cancer and she is gone?
She's still around. She learned the importance of liver cleanse, and from then on she was very careful with her diet and did detox regularly. You know, a lot of friends spend a lot of money, in the end their health becomes worse. This is the cheap remedy.